Welcome to episode 5, the episode about shoes. If you have flat feet, orthotics, you need to find shoes. And that's a real pain in the ass. And in this video, I'm going to show you my experience and how I solved it once and for all. If you want to be able to solve it as well, well, check out my video. Your foot is abnormal, and the biggest problem you have to find shoes is normal shoes for normal feet have a different design than your flat foot. Let me explain. It's a classical shoe, and we can immediately see this curve, like all shoes have. Then we have a high upper to accommodate your foot. We have a spacing here for the arc, because they suppose people who buy this have arcs. And then there is no removable insole. Let's have a look at the mechanics of flat feet on a winter insole. Let me put my foot in my old flat feet position. You see what happens? My arc gets squashed completely. So it will push against the arc of the shoe. Then my feet are going over the edge of the insole. So that means it will be pushing against the edge of your shoe. And if you put in your orthotic, you need extra space to accommodate the orthotic. And now we can see there is no more gap between the heel of the shoe and the orthotic, because nowadays I don't need it anymore. The traditional manufacturers, they don't provide removable insoles.
Let's have a look now at normal feet mechanics.
I'm gonna put my foot now on this insole in a normal position, because I'm able to do that now. So instead of pointing outwards, a normal foot points inward. Instead of having a flat upper arc, you have a filled up upper arc. You also have the arc that will follow the shape of the shoe, and you don't need an insole. I push it till the end, and I can put my thumb behind my foot. So that's an indication that here I have space left for my little toe. In the past, I always had problems there because it was pointing outwards, but now if I stand straight with my normal stance, it's pushing inward, so I don't have that problem anymore. So here you see my left foot, the green part, flat foot, and the pink part is normal foot. The first thing you notice, my feet are smaller now, that's one. Then this goes inward, so no more difficulties with the edge. Third point, you have this space now, this is called the arc imprint. So this is at your disposal right now. So this complete region is tilting outward. And the fourth thing that's not visible, you don't need an orthotic anymore. So you will be nicely snug onto your heel. Your shoe will pass here, like so. And your feet will be nicely snug and fit into your beautiful, beautiful shoe. So here we see the conclusion of normal feet versus flat feet. So a normal foot has the ability to fit into a high upper, you also have an arc, and because your toes are diverted inward, there's no problem with the curved toe box, and there's no removable insole, so there's no problemo. But flat feet are like just the opposite. You have a flat arc, there is no arc, so you're squeezing the arc section in your shoe, and your feet, your toes are diverting outward, so you're continuously crushed against that edge. And on top of that, you need bigger shoes because you have an insole slash orthotic. So with all these factors against me, I needed to go to a special place where they sell special shoes for people with flat feet. So removable insoles, bigger shoes, and that's when I discovered a special store. Special store. I can straight away tell you this was no special store. This was just a store where they had a 46, 47, 48, 49, and a 50. But all the shoes I loved in model, were a max 46, so that was no solution. Then you go to the special section and they provide you with a 47. It's not the shoe you want. It's not that beautiful boot or any other boot you see in a magazine, or for that matter, this beautiful boot. This was no option for me. It was a classical shoe, not the model I wanted, with belts and ugly design, but that was the option for me. So if you try on the shoe, there's one big problem. My foot, both of them are 45s, but the left one with that little toe is like a 46, and with orthotic a 47. This means that my entire foot will snugly fit a 45. But if you go to a 47, this section is way up. This section is wider. The arc is also bigger. Your foot is completely loose in the shoe. And this is what happens if you are standing on your orthotic.
Because it's so big, this 47 or 48, you will be pushed outward and you will slide off the orthotic. Let me demonstrate. I put my foot on it and then I just let it happen. And what's happening? This is happening inside the shoe. I'm sliding off the orthotic and I'm being pushed against the curved edge of the shoe. This is pushing. My feet are being crushed against the wall, and this I feel I am sliding off the shoe completely.
So in the end, even this special store was not working because it was just a big 40, a bigger shoe, a 47, 48, 49, and these were too big for me. As explained, this was too high, too wide, which has this effect that I slide off the orthotic in that shoe. So there's one more option, orthopedic shoes. So orthopedic shoes are shoes for people who are no longer helped with orthotics, and regular shoes still have a lot of pain, like I did. So I went to my specialist who makes my orthotics, a really nice guy, super craftsman, and he just told me, look, in your case, I already gave you an orthotic with the maximum correction. It's not even supposed to be that high of an arc. And the only thing I can do is make a wider toe box. The disadvantage of these orthotic shoes is it takes 6 to 8 weeks to create only one pair. They're super ugly. And if you have a look at some of them here, you'll see how beautiful they really are. And then compare them to nice classical shoes that are ready to wear, ready to buy, ready to be delivered online. And I think there are no words needed to see the difference between normal shoes and orthopedic shoes. If orthotic shoes don't work, you need surgery. But surgery is for episode 7. So now you have seen how easy it is to create normal feet if you went to episode 3. The advantage is you can buy all the shoes you want. I'm going to take you on a ride now and show you the old method on how I needed to crawl in shoes with my orthotic and destroy them and test them before I could buy only one pair, and compare that to the ease I have now when I try on new shoes with my normal feet in the blink of an eye. Here you see my collection of shoes where I still need to go to the store and destroy them with my orthotic. So here you see normal shoes and sport shoes. I put in the orthotic like so, and then I checked if there was a gap. You see the gap there? And if that gap, if I could put my thumb between the heel and the orthotic, it was okay. Then I put in my foot. And then I needed to flex it like so. Really, really already destroyed the shoe for someone else. And feel here if that little pinky wasn't too far. And now you see it's nicely filled because I'm standing higher. But the thing is, if you stand, you're not having a normal stance. No, because you are standing with flat feet. So you immediately see that here this thing is being squashed by the arc that is created on the orthotic. And this really, really hurts. It's pushing into your foot. So through time, I developed a natural fat pillow.
people with normal feet, they don't have this natural fat pillow. So now I'm going to really stand. You can see a force going that way and a force going that way. But now if I keep them normal, this goes inward and my feet go that way. Then, to make matters even nicer, if you go sporting, you have removable insoles, so you take it out. You take your sports orthotic, because you cannot put this orthotic into that one. No, because if you sweat on that one, you will have this result. You will have a complete imprint of your sweat. And if it sweats too much, you will have this sweat from over months and months. And then it will start to crack and it will completely destroy your orthotic. So you need special orthotics, same thing here. You put them in, you need to try them on, you push them forward and you are looking for that gap. Sports shoes, however, they do have a big toe box, but they don't fix your feet pointing outward and here pointing inward.
Now let's have a look at my new collection and how I try on shoes today.
This brings me to my new collection. These are my new shoes, really beautiful shoes, the ones I've always dreamed of, but I could never buy them because they didn't have my size, a 46, and I always had problems with my toes. I can even wear sneakers now. They are just completely flexible. These ones as well, flexible. And then these are my recent ones. These are really good solid boots, but you don't need this to create good feet. No, you need feet that will do the job, because those shoes, these shoes won't do the job for you. So these shoes are one of my favorite shoes, but I can never wear them because it's with an elastic. Good developed arcs here. And it's really high, so it's really loose. But now, with my normal feet, I also have an arc and I can fill up this space. And I don't need to put an orthotic in, so I can just easily, without any problem. And that's it, man. It's just that easy. I know it's crazy for some people with normal feet, but for people with flat feet, you don't need to put in your orthotics anymore. And I have space. And it's the same size, so I ordered them online, so it's a size 12. So I know for a fact that this one will fit perfectly as well. And it's just a really, really, really beautiful boot. It's an amazing boot. I have a thumb in the back. I can put a thumb in the back. And if I put my heel inside, I still here have space. So my little toe is there. I have space because you need it, because when you're standing, your feet will do like this. They will like try to grab. And then it's just, it's a delight to walk on these shoes.
And the bonus is online shopping, baby. No more trying shoes in the store. You know your size, you go online, you order them, they get delivered at your doorstep, and you have your brand new shoes. Check out how many shoes I have right now since I have created my normal feet.
Thank you for watching episode 5, where JJ explained all he knows about flat feet versus shoes. Nowadays, he's like me, he has normal feet, but he needs to wear shoes, and I have these beautiful paws. Anyway, I'm pretty tired right now, I think I will see you back in episode 6. Bye bye! Just can't win the day, despite of all your